the music of Italian Baroque composer Domenico Scarlatti. He lived around the same era as Bach. It was kind of fashionable in those days to write one movement keyboard sonatas, which is from this one and adapted for flute and guitar. Our next composer is German composer Georg Philipp Telemann, one of the most prolific composers in the history of music. He also was a good friend of Bach's and was godfather to one of Bach's sons, C.P.E. Bach. This sonata is in four movements. There's a dolce, a scherzando, a largo, and a vivace. Thank you.
The composer of the next piece is Ferdinando Carulli. Ferdinando Carulli was born in Naples, Italy, and he moved around a little bit. He moved to Milan, Italy, and later to Paris, which was a real musical capital during that time. And he also had married a French woman, and he was successful there before he moved there, so that explains his geography anyway. Carulli's one of the most famous composers of guitar music. He wrote more than 400 pieces, and he among those pieces are three concertos. And he also wrote some interesting pieces for guitar and piano. His son was a pianist. And his most famous work is a method book, which was published in 1810, but it's still very commonly used today. I think I myself has like 3 or 4 copies of it sitting around. Later in his life, he became a self-publisher, which is probably a good business move, but early in his career, he was published by many other publishers. So I hope you enjoy one of Carulli's many pieces for flute and guitar. It's a 2-movement duet. Thank you. now making a big transition into a contemporary composer, Joseph Virgilio, who is from not far from here. He's born in Orange, and he attended Rutgers University. He studied composition and music in school, and then went off to get a real job. But he's composed through most of his life, and this is his latest. He's written a lot of choral music and things like that, but he's also written a few flute and guitar things for us, and this is the latest. Just a few notes about the music. This is a lighter piece for Joe. Usually he writes pieces that are harder on the ears. You know, this is a little bit easier on the ears. And he describes his music as linear-driven with vertical structures that are more chromatic than diatonic. Does that make sense to you?
Okay.
Sounds like contemporary music.
Thank you.
Our next composer is Ernesto Cordero, a living composer and guitarist. He was born in New York and raised in Puerto Rico. Fantasia Mulata gets its inspiration from the native music and local surroundings in Puerto Rico. It starts with the sound of the birds, and then you'll hear a solemn place where we're like passing by the church. And then there's a more lively place, which is depicting the market. And then you'll hear a big fiesta at the end, which also features a nice big guitar solo. So here's Fantasia Mulata. Thank you.
The next two pieces are original compositions of mine. They were written very recently, a few months ago. The first piece, I think it's listed as Prelude, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, Prelude also has the title of Sacred Space. I borrowed liberally from the Bach Gounod Ave Maria piece. I borrowed the melody and added my own harmony, which is kind of influenced by jazz. And I think an improvisatory spirit from jazz is also present in my music. I was just thinking the other day, how come my music sounds different than some of the other pieces on the program? And maybe it's that jazz influence. So after the prelude is Suddenly Sanguine, and it's kind of influenced by bossa nova Latin music, and it kind of sounds melancholy until a certain section where it sounds optimistic or sanguine. Thank you. Next piece is a big work. It's 5 movements. Is that right? It's 5 movements.
Yeah.
And the composer is Marcelo Coronel. He lives in Argentina. He was born in Buenos Aires, and he lives about 200 miles away from there in a river city called Rosario. Coronel says that in his music, he tries to fuse academic classical music, European music, with native Argentinian music. And I think it's really like, it's not usually the traditional tango, but it's more like folkloric music. The piece is called El Orzón del Medio, which translates as the middle trunk of the house. And it's dedicated to his wife, who is the centerpiece of his own home. And by the way, this is written for Coronel to play guitar, and he also has a duo called the Meridiano Duo, the Meridian Duo. The first piece is a zamba or samba, which is a free couples dance. The second movement changes between 6/8 time to 3/4 time, and the piece is in 2 sections with various guitar solo interludes. The third movement, the center movement, is called Vidala, and it's lyrical, calm, and melancholic. It's a nice love song, I think. The fourth movement is Carnavalito, Little Carnival. It's a lively dance, and it's from Northwest Argentina. It's imitating music from Northwest Argentina, like music for bamboo flute and a guitar-like instrument called the charango. The last movement is called Gato. It's a couples dance, and it's in an unusual form of, A-A-A-B-A-B-A. So it's interesting, unusual form. So I hope you enjoy a big piece from 2011 by Marcelo Coronel. Thank you.
Fernando Carlos Tavolaro, another living composer and guitarist from Argentina. He was born in 1953. The piece is entitled A Milonga. This is number 5 of a group of milongas. A milonga is an Argentine, Uruguayan, and Southern Brazilian dance.
Thank you.
I hope you're enjoying this Argentinian music, because we have a little bit more for you. The composer of the next piece, also from Buenos Aires, Máximo Diego Pujol. He was born in 1957, and he's also a guitarist and composer. He's having a lot of success in the classical music world, I think. This piece is called Tres Piezas Marginales, and the three marginal places are poor places in the suburbs. I want to say ghettos. The first movement, Caserío, is a small place with a few poor houses. Baldío, the second movement, is also a milonga, and it's a piece of land with nothing, or a wasteland. The last movement, Potrero, is a piece of land where poor children play soccer, and it's a very playful movement. Thank you.
We're going to close our program with another piece that's by a living composer. This is John Maurice Mora, a Frenchman who now lives in Spain. We've been playing a lot of his music and have become very good friends by email. He tells us that the Choro 2020 was written and published in early 2020 before the pandemic. So he says its nostalgic writing is not the consequence of the pandemic, but really Brazilian music, which is often melancholic. I might add too that he dedicated this piece to us since we're the first ones to play it.